I appreciate your patience. He is having so much fun on his first trip to Iowa. People have been so excited to talk to him, and I know you are too. And I want to bring him up here, but first I'd like to start us off and invite up Dusty and Teresa Enright, residents of Ankeny, and they will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Cedar Rapids, and we did something a little bit different. You know, a lot of times people come to Iowa and they, you know, they sit on a hay bale and they talk to the media and they say, that's what Iowa is all about. Well, we know that Iowa is diverse. It's not only our farms, it's our small towns, it's even what we think are big cities. Well, the man I get a chance to introduce tonight's seen a pretty big city before, and maybe Des Moines and Cedar Rapids isn't the biggest city he's ever been in, but he's had a chance to talk to Iowans. He's had a chance to talk to them in their living rooms, on their front porches, as he's walking down the street. In fact, it was like the scene from Rocky. He's walking down the street to Cedar Rapids, and people were coming out of their houses to talk to him, to tell him what they wanted in America, to talk about the three great challenges that we're faced with in our country. We need a strong America if we're going to be the kind of America we need to be in the future. We need to make sure that we're prosperous economically if we're going to create the jobs and opportunities for the future. And he talked to many Iowans about that today. And he also talked to Iowans about the growth of government, fiscal irresponsibility. What's happening in Washington right now, at a very time when we're trying to fund the troops in the field, Democrats are piling on pork barrel projects for their districts back home instead of respecting the service of our men and women in uniform. And he talked to them about that as well. Well, we know all too well in Iowa that we've got to make a choice.